right? So before we move on to the next topic, which is partnership operations, let us discuss the last activity that we had, which is the preparation of your your journal entries as well as the basic statement of financial position for partnership formation scenario 3. Okay, yung merami tayong sole proprietors na mag-establish ng ating partnership. Okay. So, let us first recall yung mga data na involved doon sa ating problem. So, we have Duhon, Ellis, and Farmer. They are sole proprietors and they will be establishing a partnership. You are given the balances of their accounting reports. And you're also given the adjustments doon sa baba. Okay? So, sabi doon, there will be an allowance, 10% for the receivables. There will be an adjustment for the inventory. There will be a mortgage that is going to be recognized for Duhon. Ellis will recognize unpaid salaries and land and equipment as well as furniture will be adjusted for their fair values. So those are the adjustments that we're going to have. All right. So let us first proceed with Also, we are going to prepare the bonus method using scenarios A, B, C, D, and E. Okay? After the partnership formation. So let us first prepare the adjusting entries on the books of Duhon. So basically, this will be the adjusting entries. First, we are going to recognize the allowance for bad debts of 28,000. This is based on 10% of the carrying amount of the receivables. We will decrease the inventory of Duhon by 10,000. We will recognize the mortgage of 30,000. And we will increase the land value by 35,000. After which, we are going to prepare the closing entries. And with the closing entries, we already computed the adjusted capital balance. So the adjusted capital balance of Duhon is 657,000. Which will also be contributed. So for the investment of Duhon, no problem. This will be prepared in the books of the partnership already. So same, those items that were closed in the books of Duhon will be invested in the books of the partnership. So this is 657,000. That's the adjusted capital investment. Next, for Ellis, we are going to recognize allowance for bad debts, decrease in inventory, recognition of salaries payable, and decrease in the value of the equipment. Closing entries in the books of Ellis, giving us 402,000 as adjusted capital, which will then be invested in the books of the partnership with using this journal entry. So the adjusted capital for Ellis prior to bonus method later on is 402,000. Books of Farmer, we recognize allowance for bad debts, increase in inventory, and decrease in the value of the furniture. The adjusted capital of Farmer will be 469,500, which will be the amount of the net investment of Farmer upon recognition in the books of the partnership. So, with that, we are going to proceed with letter A of the bonus method. First assumption in letter A is we are going to have equal capital ratio. So if we have equal capital ratio, you simply get the actual investments of Duhon, Ellis, and Farmer with a total amount of 1,528,500, which will then be divided equally. Okay? Divided equally among the three. So it's going to be 509,500 for each. So the adjustment will be a deduction in Duhon and an addition to Ellis and Farmer respectively. Journal entry will be debit to Duhon Capital, credit to Ellis and Farmer Capital for the amount provided in our table above. Second, if there is a 50-30-20 ratio, same process, you get the total actual capital, you distribute it based on 50-30 and 20%. So that's going to be these amounts. Okay, get the adjustment. So in this case, farmer will be deducted or will be debited because of the deduction here, and Duhon and Ellis will be credited for 107,250 and 56,550 each. Okay. Letter C. Ratio is 30-30-40. So what we are going to do is to recognize the ratio, or the to provide the agreed capital based on the ratio provided. So in this case, you're going to reduce the capital of Duhon by 198,450 and increase the capital of Ellis and Farmer, okay, respectively. So what you're going to do is to debit Duhon and credit Ellis and Farmer based on the amounts computed. For letter D, what was given to you is 1 is to 3 is to 2. Okay, this is not percentage. This is actually whole numbers. So what you're going to do is basically you're going to use your calculator and you're going to get a percentage, okay, based on the ratios provided. So in this case, if that is 1 is to 3 is to 2, so that's 1 plus 3 plus 2, total is 6. So let's get the ratio or the fraction. So for Duhon will get 1 over 6, which is 16.67%. Okay? Ellis will get 3 over 6. That's 50%. And Farmer will get 2 over 6, which is 1/3 or 33.33%. Okay? So if you're not going to round off your amounts, you're going to get exact amounts here. So what's going to happen? In the case of Duhon will have a deduction of 402,250. Ellis and Farmer will have increases, which will result to this journal entry. So that's basically how it is for the bonus method of the company or the partners under letter D. Then finally, letter E, ratio of 2 is to 3 is to 5. So similar approach, you get your calculator and you compute the ratio by getting the total first of the respective ratios for each partner. So 2 plus 3 plus 5, that's 10. So 2 over 10 is 20%, 3 over 10 is 30%, 5 over 10 is 50%. So you distribute that based on that ratio. So Duhon will be deducted or will have a negative adjustment. So that's a debit. Ellis and Farmer will have credit adjustments. So that's basically the journal entries there. So last thing that we're going to do anyway, this is in the assumption that there will be no bonus method yet. Anyway, the only difference, if in case you're going to use bonus method, is there will be a different balance of your capital. But in the case of the statement of financial position, regardless of whether bonus method is used or not, your total asset is still 2,548,000. Your liabilities will be accounts payable, notes payable, mortgage payable, and salaries payable. Okay, so you just get the total of those four. And then your equity will be the capital balances of Duhon, Ellis, and Farmer. So, as long as you did the correct process and most probably evidenced by a balanced statement of financial position, then we have no problem there. Okay? So, we can now... So, that's basically the discussion for our activity. Alright. So, let us proceed with partnership operations. So basically, after you establish your partnership, so nakapag-form na tayo ng partnership, nagawa na natin yung iba't ibang partnership or yung partner capital allocations and redistributions para doon sa desired capital balances, we can now proceed with our operations. In other words, mag-ooperate na yung negosyo, normal operating business, normal process na natin, kung magbebenta man tayo ng goods, etc. So all processes that are going to be involved, okay, in your operations is similar to a sole proprietorship. Kaya hindi na natin babalikan yan Because in sole proprietorship, regardless if that is merchandising or service business, same lang yung journal entries. What is the main issue in partnership operation? The main issue in partnership operation is, hindi kasi katulad ng sole proprietorship na kapag kumita, lahat ng kita ibibigay mo lang kay sole proprietor. Walang problema kasi minsanan, i-close mo lang yung income summary account doon sa capital account ng sole proprietor. That's not the case for partnership. Because in a partnership, you need to, first of all, number one, after determining your net income or net loss, number two is you need to determine how you are going to distribute the profits or the losses. Okay? So that's why we have two parts for this discussion. We have the distribution of profits and second is distribution of losses. Okay? So anyway, that's the case here. So in partnership operation, the main issue is how you are going to distribute and how you are going to allocate the income among the partners. Okay, so yun yung focus natin for this session. So, income determination muna tayo. So, income determination is basically the process of determining the balance of the income summary, or in other words, determining the balance of the or the amount of the net income or net loss, similar to how you determine it in a sole proprietorship, kunin mo lang yung income minus expenses. So, yun lang naman yun. So, that is the first step in order for us to account for partnership operations. Aalamin muna natin kung magkano ang kita or lugi ng ating negosyo. So, the next thing there is yung tinatawag nga nating allocations ng ating income or loss, also known as profit or loss sharing. Okay? Profit and loss sharing natin. Okay? So, paano ba yung process ng profit and loss sharing? Okay? Same din lang, parang doon din sa ating sole proprietorship. Di ba? Kung babalikan mo yung closing entries ng sole proprietorship, what is the first step? First step ng sole proprietorship closing entries, close all the revenues in your income summary account. Second step, close all expenses in the income summary account. So, tapos ka na sa steps 1 and 2. So, ano na lang third step mo doon? I-close mo muna yung, depende sa'yo kung unahin mo yung withdrawal or yung income summary. Pero generally, i-close mo muna yung income summary doon sa ating capital balances. So, or doon sa ating capital accounts. Now, the thing there is, magkano? Or magkano yung papasok sa bawat capital account? Yun lang naman yung gagawin natin dito. So, similar to what we are discussing, ito entries natin, di ba? First step ng closing entry. Ito naman yung entry natin, second step ng closing entry. So, ganun lang. Wala namang issue dyan. Kayang-kaya natin gawin yan. Okay, so go to example. Para lang ma-recall natin, no? So, assuming you have service income and the following items here of the expenses, question is, how much is your net income or how much will be the balance of your income summary after preparing step 1 and step 2 of the closing entries? So with this, closing entries, step 1 and step 2, alam na natin yung income, alam natin yung expense, magkano ang balance? That's going to be, present lang muna natin yung journal entries. So for the first journal entry, we're going to recognize a debit to service income and credit to income summary. And then for the closing of the expenses, debit natin yung income summary, okay, for the total of the expenses na binawas natin. Okay? So from there, magkano na yung ating income summary balance, okay? So the income summary is 4,415,060 pesos. Okay, credit balance. Okay? So question, if the income summary balance is a credit balance, ano bang nangyari? Kumita ba tayo or nalugi? Okay, paki-type yung sagot sa chat box. Letter A, kumita. Letter B, nalugi. So the answer is, we earned a profit. Okay, kumita tayo. Okay, so from there, profit tayo ngayon. Ang tanong, paano mo i-distribute yung profit? Okay? So the distribution of your profit will be dependent or will depend on, of course, the agreement of the partners. shares. Okay? So that's the basic rule. Profit sharing is generally based on the agreement of the partners. Okay? The partnership being consensual, okay? Therefore, lahat mapag-aagrihan yan. Okay? Pag-aagrihan kung magkano or paano i-share ang profit, pwedeng equally, pwedeng based on capital balance, pwedeng based on average capital balance, beginning capital balance, ending capital balance, based on original capital ratio, etc. Kung ano yung napag-usapan. Okay? So, kung ano yung napag-usapan, sundan lang natin. Ganun lang naman kadali sa partnership operation. Okay? So, kung walang ano, kung walang agreement based on the provisions ng partnership, syempre ang gagawin natin diyan, susundan natin yung capital contribution balances. Kasi by way of tawag dito, inference, by way of inference, yung capital contribution or capital balances ng partners ang nagre-represent ng ownership nila doon sa partnership. So in the absence of any profit or loss sharing ratio, we are going to use the capital balances. Okay, that's going to be the basis there. Okay? So ano ang issue ngayon dito? Eh syempre kung based on capital contribution 'yan, eh paano si industrial partner? Eh di ba? Si industrial partner, wala namang capital balance yan sa simula. E paano siya mag-share, di ba? So, ang concept is you are going to give a just and equitable share doon sa ating industrial partner. Okay? Bago natin bigyan ng share yung ating capitalist partners. So, ang isang rule dyan, paano natin malalaman yung just and equitable share ni industrial partner? Ang usual practice, kung magkano yung share nung lowest cap or nung yung share nung capitalist partner na pinakamababa, okay, ganun din yung share nung industrial partner. So in other words, the share of the capitalist partner with the lowest profit share will be the same, okay, as with the industrial partner. So yun yung usual practice. Pero ang general na term na ginagamit kasi, just and equitable share or just equitable share. Okay? So, next tayo. Yan, yung sinabi ko, di ba? Kapag walang specific, okay, na ibinibigay sa industrial partner, ang natatanggap niya is yung share din ng capitalist partner with the least profit share. Okay? So, yan yung rule natin kanina. Letter C, paano kapag siya ay capitalist na nga na partner, industrial partner pa? So what's our rule there? Ang rule natin, bibigyan natin siya ng share as the industrial partner and then susunod, pag may naiwan pang profit, paghahati-hatian na nung lahat ng capitalist partner. So kumbaga ang labas kasi dyan, kailangan mabigyan natin ng equitable share yung partner na hindi lang nagbigay ng capital or ng pera, but also contributed yung time niya, yung skills niya, or expertise niya dun sa negosyo. Kaya ang labas, separate profit share muna as industrial partner, and then kasunod capitalist, as capitalist partner for the remaining profits. Yan, so ganun yan. So what are the general, okay, arbitrary agreements in case of profit sharing? Ano yung mga usual na may encounter natin? Okay? So, usual encounter natin dyan, number one, yung equal. Yan yung pinakamadali. Para walang away. Kung magkano kinita, sige, hati-hatiin natin. Ilan ba tayong partners? Ganyan. So, kumita ng 100,000, lima tayong magpa-partners. So, meron tayong tagdi 20,000 each. O, diba? So, walang problema. Ganun yung hatian. Pwede rin specified ratio or percentage. Okay? Similar dun sa bonus method na ginawa natin, pwedeng sabihin natin, o kay partner A, 20%, kay partner B, 15%, kay partner C, dahil mas malaki siya, 40% ang share niya, ganun. So may mga ganun, arbitrary ratio or percentage. So yun yung pwede. Okay? Pwede rin na mag-agree kayo based on capital ratio. Okay? So ang agreement ninyo, sundan natin kung ano yung capital ratio, tapos ratio and proportion, hatiin natin yung profits. Okay? So, madami kasing klase yan. Merong original capital. Yan yung unang-unang capital balance ninyo upon formation. Second is beginning capital. Yan yung at the beginning of the year. Ending capital, end of the year. Pwede ring average capital ang gagamitin. Pag sinabing average capital, dalawang klaseng computation yan. Meron yung tinatawag natin na simple average, which is beginning plus ending divided by 2. Okay? At meron din yung weighted average na ang ginagawa is dinedetermine kung ilan yung balance at each given period of time, okay, during the year. Tapos, weighted siya dun sa number of months kung gaano siya katagal na outstanding. So anyway, may example tayo dyan later. Don't worry. Okay, so yun yung sa weighted. Okay? So yun, pwede yan. Pwede yan. So pwedeng equally, pwedeng simple ratio, pwedeng capital ratio. Alright, so what are other arbitrary agreements na pwede nating gamitin? So, pwedeng magpo-provide ka ng interest. Okay? Yan, interest. So, anong mangyari dyan? So, pag sinabi nating interest, hindi siya yung as in interest income, ha? Ang concept lang, parang yung capital balance ng partners, kukumpitan natin siya ng certain percentage as if interest kasi parang dahil nga nag-invest sila sa partnership, parang yun yung value nung investment nila. Parang ganun siya. So, pwedeng based on actual capital balance. Okay, so kung ano yung balance niya at the end of the year, multiply natin nung certain percentage, yun na. Pwede rin na average capital. Okay, usually, mas magandang average capital ang gamitin kasi it is more reflective of the actual balance of the partner. Kasi tignan mo to, kapag sinabi, kunyari, na bibigyan natin ng interest on the ending capital balance. Anong gagawin ng mga partners? Eh di maglagay na lang ako ng malaking pera at the end of the year para mas malaki yung percentage ko, 'di ba? Which is not actually justifiable or not fair kasi parang ang labas hindi naman nagamit yung pera mo or yung investment mo all throughout the year kasi end of the year ka lang naman nag-invest. So hindi naman napakinabangan ng partnership 'yon. So, mas equitable na ang gamitin is yung average capital para reflective yung gaano ba siya katagal na nandun sa partnership books or nasa partnership records at nagamit sa operations. Kaya usually average yan. Meron din yung isa, yung bibigyan siya ng interest in excess of a specific investment. Like example, kung ang capital requirement ng partnership, each partner should have 100,000 at least. So, capital balance, 100,000 every year. Ngayon, bibigyan natin siya ng interest for every amount in excess of the 100,000. So, kunyari, si partner A, sabi niya, sige, mag-invest pa ako ng additional 100. So, aside from the 100,000 minimum investment, naghulog pa siya or nagbigay pa siya ng 100,000. So, bigyan natin ng interest yung excess doon sa minimum na 100,000. So, may mga ganun tayong examples. Okay? Pwede ring magbigay pa ng salaries. Again, itong salaries na to, hindi siya yung as in salaries expense, ha? This pertains to salaries in a form of profit sharing lang. Kumbaga parang dahil siya si managing partner, bigyan natin siya ng parang sweldo. Okay, ganun yun. Pwede ring bonus. Yung bonus naman, binibigay natin kapag natuwa tayo kasi mas mataas sa expected yung ating profit. Ganun. So, parang ang example dyan is, if our expected profit is only 1 million, tapos lumampas ng 1 million yung profit natin, then we are going to provide a bonus. Parang bonus policy or additional profit share. Parang ganun yung mangyari. Sino ang bibigyan mo ng bonus? Usually, kung sino yung managing partner or kung sino yung partner na directly naka-contribute or naging dahilan kung bakit tumaas yung profit. Which is generally, managing partner naman talaga. Okay? Meron din yung number 7, multiple bases. Pag sinabi nating multiple bases, yan yung pinaghalo-halo na. May interest na, may salaries pa, may bonus pa, tapos may remaining profits pa. Yun na yung pinakamahirap. Okay? Yung pinaghalo-halong bases. Pero hindi naman talaga siya as in mahirap kasi you simply need to follow the information given. No problem with that. Okay? So let us have an example para ma-gets natin yung mga iba't ibang schemes or iba't ibang arbitrary agreements with regards to profit sharing. So, assuming we have ABC partnership, tapos ang kinita niya ay 600,000. So, kumita si ABC partnership ng 600,000. Ang partners natin, si Anastasio, si Balagtas, at saka si Corazon. Okay? So, yun yung basic na na item natin. So, ano daw ang kwento? Okay? Letter A, okay? Ang kwento letter A, ang profit sharing daw nila equally. Kwento letter B, ang profit sharing ay 3:2:4. Kwento letter C, profit share is 30%, 20%, 50%. Okay? So, unahin muna natin si kwento A. Okay? Kwento A, wala namang problema yan. The partners will share the profits equally. Magkano yung kinita? 600,000. Ilang partners? Tatlo. Divided by 3, tagdo 200,000. So, basic computation, walang masyadong challenge, kaya usually hindi lumalabas sa exam yan. Okay, hindi rin yan lalabas sa board exam, just in case. Okay, so, simple. So, alam natin yung step 1 and step 2 ng closing entries, ha? So, automatic alam natin na yung balance ng income summary, credit. Kasi income nga siya. So, kung i-close na natin siya, i-debit mo na si income summary. And then, you credit the respective capital balances, okay, for the amount of their profit share, which is in this case, simpleng-simple, divided by 3 mo lang yung kinita, so 200,000 each. O, diba? Very simple, walang challenge. Okay, so yan yung sagot natin sa letter A. Sa letter B daw, ang ratio natin is 3:2:4. Okay, yan yung kwento. So basically, independent cases to, ha? Ang ginagawa lang natin, in-example lang natin. Okay, so paano yun? 3:2:4, kunin mo yung total, then that is going to be 3/9 or 1/3, 2/9 at saka 4/9. So gagamitin mo yung ratio na yun or yung fraction na yun, i-multiply mo sa 600,000, lalabas yung profit share natin as follows. Anastasio for 200,000, Balagtas for 133,333, and Corazon for 266,667. Yan. Generally, if you're going to solve for this, huwag kang mag-round off talaga. The only item that you will round off most probably will be the final answer. So that's the rule in accounting. Huwag kang mag-round off unless specifically stated in the problem. And if in case you need to do round off, the round off will only be done for the final answer. Okay? Or yung pinaka end result ng computation mo. So anyway, in this case, journal entry natin, same pa rin, debit natin yung income summary, credit natin si Anastasio Balagtas and Corazon Capital based on the amount computed in our problem. Okay? So ito yung computation, ito yung journal entry. Yung journal entry, wala namang pagbabago. Laging ganyan yung entry. Ang mag-iiba lang yung amount. Okay? Next. Paano kapag 30-20-50? Di ganun din. Diba pag tinotal mo to 100%? So ang gawin mo, kunin mo yung 30% ng 600, 20% ng 600, 50% ng 600, lalabas to. So ito na yung na-compute mong profit share, yun na rin yung papasok sa capital balances ni Anastasio Balagtas and Corazon. Diba? So, that is how it works. Yan. Letter D. Okay? What if? Okay? Letter D. What if? Okay? The partners have capital balances as follows. Okay? So, beginning at saka ending capital na ibigay sa'yo. Tapos, ang sinabi, the partners share profits based on average capital balance. Okay? So, assume pa rin natin na 600,000 yung profit. Okay, 600,000 pa rin yung profit. Ang profit sharing daw, okay, will be based on the average capital balance. So, what does that mean? Ibig sabihin, computin mo yung average capital ni A, ni B, at saka ni C. Kunin mo yung total. Tapos, ratio and proportion, multiply mo dun sa 600,000. Yung lalabas, yun yung profit share. Okay, nung each partner. So, bago natin i-reveal yung sagot, okay, 5 minutes, pakisolve yung profit share ni A, B, at saka ni C. Okay? Si ABS, siya pa rin yung ano, ha? Sila pa rin si Anastacio Balagtas at saka Corazon. So for letter D, the first thing that we're going to do is to determine the average capital. And then from there, we will determine the ratio of each partner. And then we multiply it to the 600,000 na income. So how are we going to do that? So solve natin. Paano nakuha si 270, 177,500 at saka 342,000? So simple lang yan. Diba? Kung maglalabas ka ng calculator at gagawin natin yung simple average, ang gagawin mo lang 260,000 plus 280,000, kasi di-divide natin ng 2, edi 270 na yun. So yun na yung average. Kay B, 160,000 plus 195,000 divided by 2, that's 177,500. Kay C, 320,000 plus 364,000 divided by 2, that's 342,000. So, yun na yun. So, from there, yun na yung ating average capital. Pag-adin na lang natin. So, 270 plus 177,500 plus 342, then that's already 789,500. Ginagamit lang natin to for purposes na malaman natin yung ratio. So, paano yun? 270 divided by 789,500 times 600,000, ito yung kay Anastacio. Si Balagtas, 177,500 divided by 789,500, ito yung kay Balagtas, 134,895.50. Or kung gusto mo i-round off, that's already 896. Tapos si Corazon, 342 divided by 789,500 times 600,000, ito yung sa kanya, 259,911. So you can round it off to the nearest peso. So this is 205,193. This is 134,896. And this is going to be 259,911. So walang kaso. So yan na yung sagot natin. So di ba, kunin mo lang yung average capital. Okay, next tayo. What if we are going to have interest, okay, interest na to, we are going to give interest plus remainder daw equally, okay? So we have the same information. This is the beginning and ending capital balances of Anastacio, Balagtas, and Corazon. And the partners share profits by giving 20% interest on beginning capital and sharing the remainder equally. Okay. So, try natin to kung kaya nyong masagutan. So, ang gagawin nyo muna, ibibigyan nyo sila ng tagte 20% interest based on beginning capital balance. Tapos, yung matitirang profit, hahatiin daw equally. Alright. So, what will be the steps in doing this? So, in solving these particular types of problems, it is better kung gagawa ka ng table. So let us prepare a tabular presentation of how to distribute the profit. So ito yung solution niyan. So ganyan. Ang gagawin muna natin, gagawa tayong table para makuha natin yung share ng partner for each aspect or for each area. So di ba? Ang sinabi, bigyan daw natin ng 20% interest yung mga partners based on their beginning capital. So, saan nakuha tong 52, 32, at saka 64? Ang gagawin mo lang, yung 260 times 20%, 160 times 20%, 320 times 20%. Yun lang. So, pag binigay mo na yung interest, ito na yung total. Eh, di ba ang kinita ng partnership, 600,000? So, kung ang interest na naibigay mo na is 148,000 all in all, yun yung total nitong tatlong to, may remainder pa o may remaining profit pa na 452,000, which can be allocated according dun sa profit share nila, it will be allocated equally. So, divide by 3. So, lalabas to. Okay? So, ngayon, ang issue mo dyan, may butal na 1 centavo kasi syempre ang tawag dito, meron talagang mawawalan. So, bahala ka na kung saan mo ilalagay yung piso. So, usually, in this case, dahil malaki naman yung interest na natanggap ni Corazon, edi sa kanya na lang yung kulang na 1 centavo. Or kung naka-round off siya, sa kanya na yung kulang na piso. Wala namang issue yan. So, yun lang naman yung concern natin dyan. So, kunin mo na yung total afterwards. So, si Anastasio, 52 plus 156667. Okay, so ito yung sa kanya. Si Balagtas, 32 plus 156667. Ito na yun, 182. Si Corazon, 64 plus 156666. Okay? Ito sa kanya. So, yun yung total. Basta ang goal mo dyan, dapat walang magbutal. Okay? Dapat eksaktong-eksakto yung distribution. So, matter of judgment na yan kung sinong tatanggap ng kulang na piso. Okay? So, dito, judgment call, 64 naman nakuha ni Corazon, sa kanya na lang yung kulang na piso. Immaterial naman. Tapos, journal entry, ito na yan. Debit mo ulit income summary, tapos credit mo yung capital. Okay? So, ganyan yung letter E natin. How about letter F? Okay? Ang sinabi sa letter F, partners share profits by giving 20% interest on beginning capital, 4,000 monthly salary to B, and sharing the remainder equally. Yan. Sige, try ulit natin to. Okay, so for letter F, similar process, we are going to prepare a table. So, tatlo ngayon yung hatian natin. Or tatlo yung basis ng hati. First hati, interest. Second na hati, yung salary ni B. Tapos third na hati, yung remainder. So, this is how we are going to compute. Yan. So, first, interest, yung same na amount kanina. So, binigay natin yung interest na 52, 32, and 64. So, total is 148. Next, bigyan natin ng sweldo si B. Malamang siguro siya yung managing partner. So, that's 4,000 per month times 12. So, that's going to be 48,000. So, out of the 600,000, naibigay na natin yung 148 at saka 48. So, may naiiwan pang 404. So, the 404,000 will be divided equally daw. So, divide ulit natin. So, sino yung binigyan natin ng mas mababa? Okay, so si B. Piso lang naman yan. So, kay B ko binigay yung piso kasi siya yung mas malaki na yung share. So, pwede nang siya na yung mag-absorb nung piso. Okay? So, kan lang naman yon. Anyway, limit, minimal lang naman yon. So, para sumakto lang. Okay? So, ni-round off ko to the nearest peso para mas mabilis. So, ang share ni A, 168,667. Share ni B, 214,666. Tapos kay C, 198,667. Okay? All in all, 600,000 pa rin. Okay? So, that's how we do that particular example. Yan. Now, letter G. Okay, so now letter G is going to be more complicated because this time we are going to have a bonus computation. Okay? Sabi, partner share profits by giving 50,000 salary to B, giving 15% bonus to B also based on net income, okay, and sharing the remainder in the ratio of 2:3:2. Okay. So, paano natin isosolve yan? Alright, so how are we going to solve for this problem? So, let's try to see. So, basically, tatlo ngayon ang gagawin ulit natin. Salary, tapos bonus, tapos yung remainder, 2:3:2. So, paano yung solution? Ganito. Okay. So, una, bigay natin yung salary na 50,000 kay B. Next, bigay natin yung bonus niya na 90,000. Saan? Paano na-compute yung 90,000? Di ba sinabi, bonus is equal to 15% of net income. So, kunin natin yung net income na 600,000 times 15%. So, that's going to be 90,000. Yun. Okay? So, After which, dun sa 600,000, nabigay na yung 50 at saka yung 90. So, 460 na to. Yung remainder. Paano ang hatian? 2 is to 3 is 2. Ay, sorry. Balikan natin. 2 is to 3 is to 2. So, 2 plus 2, ay 2 plus 3 plus 2 is 7. So, 2 over 7, 3 over 7, 2 over 7. So, i-multiply natin doon sa 460 na naiwan. So, ito yung magiging item. Okay, so naka-round off na rin to the nearest peso para mas mabilis. So, ano ang share ngayon ni A? Ang share ni A is 131,429. Share ni B is 197,142. Share ni C is 131,429 din. Si total natin, so this is 131,429, 337,142, and 131,429 din. Total 600,000. So, yun na yung balance natin dito. O, diba? So, ganun lang yung ating answer sa partnership operations dito sa portion na to. Okay, so let's proceed with letter H. So, we have the same information here. We have the capital balances of partners A, B, and C or Anastasio, Balagtas, and Corazon. And then, the profit sharing is now as follows. The partner share profits by giving 5,000 monthly salary to B and then giving 15% bonus to A based on net income after bonus, and sharing the remainder in the ratio of 2:3:3. Okay, so let's try first kung paano natin isosolve yan. Ang magiging pinaka-issue lang naman dyan is yung computation ng bonus. So, gagamit ka lang ng formula dyan. And then, the next is, yung remainder, okay lang naman yan. So, if we are going to give monthly salary to B na 5,000, that's going to be 5,000 times 12. Ah, ba, ito yung problem natin, no? That's going to be 5,000 times 12. Tapos 15% na bonus based on net income after bonus. And then 2:3:3. What will be our solution there? Okay, so the solution will be... So what's our solution for this problem? So ito. So first, bigay natin yung salary. Okay, what bigay natin yung salary na 60,000. That's 5,000 times 12 months. Okay, so yun. Next, bigay natin yung bonus. So, paano na-compute yung bonus? Ito siya. So, bonus is equal to 15% of net income after bonus. Kaya ang mangyari, 15% times net income minus B. Tapos, distribute natin. So, that's 15% times 600,000 minus 15% times B. So, ang mangyari, bonus is equal to 90,000 minus 15% B. So, may iwan sa side na to yung 90,000. Yung 15% B, lipat mo sa kabilang side. So, magiging plus yon. So, magiging parang 1 yon, 1 plus 15%, di ba? So, 1.15 B na yon. Is equal to 90,000. So, ang gagawin mo, divide mo to ng 1.15, divide mo rin to ng 1.15. Ang lalabas na bonus is 78,261. Ni-round off ko na siya para mas madali. So, yun na yung amount dito. Okay? So, ang naibigay na natin, salary at saka bonus. So, out of the 600,000, after natin ibawas tong dalawa, ang may iwan pa ay 461,239. Ang ginamit na ratio, 2:3:3. So, 2+3+3, that's 8. So, 2 over 8 ng amount na to is 115,435. Na-round off ko na rin siya to the nearest peso. Okay? Tapos, ganun din sa ano dalawa, kay Balagtas at saka kay Corazon. So, that's going to be 3 over 8 times 461,739. So, yun na yung balances. So, tag-173,152 sila. So, all in all, pag tinotal natin, ito na yung capital balance. So, what will be our journal entry? That's going to be debit to income summary and credit to the capital balances Okay? Tapos, yun na yung ating journal entry based on the amounts na na-compute. Okay? So, that's for letter H. Letter I. So, parehas pa rin tayo. 600,000 ang ating income. Ang profit sharing is 10% interest on ending capital, 70,000 salary to B, 15% bonus to A, based on net income after salary and interest, and sharing the remainder in the ratio of 25-40-35. Okay, so yun yung ratios natin, or yun yung profit sharing. So ilang hati ito? Interest, isang hati. Salary, pangalawang hati. Bonus, pangatlong hati. Tapos yung remainder, pang-apat. So, kumbaga, apat na hati lahat yun. Okay, sige. So, for letter I, we have the same income, 600,000, but the division of the profits will be as follows. 10% interest on ending capital balance, 70,000 salary to B, 15% bonus to A, based on net income after salary and interest. Tapos kung may iwan pa, 25-40-35. So, paano yung hatian? Ganito. So, bigay natin yung 10% interest. 28,000, 19,500, and 36,400. So, total niya is 83,900. Next, bigay natin yung salary. Yung salary, 70,000 kay B natin ibibigay. So, 70,000. Tapos yung bonus, paano daw yung computation ng bonus? Bonus is computed by giving 15% of net income after salaries and interest. So gagawin ko yung 600,000, babawasan ko muna ng salary na 70, tapos interest na 83,900. So ang magiging net amount nun is 446,100. So ang gagawin mo ngayon, computan mo ng 15% yung 446,100, dalabas yung 66,900. 15. Kaya yung bonus para kay Anastasio will be yung 66,915. Okay? Tapos may remainder pa. So out of the 600,000, after nating ibawas yung tatlo, yung interest, salary at saka bonus, may remainder pa tayo dito na 379,185. So kinuha lang natin yung 25%, 40%, and 35%. Niround off ko na ulit to the nearest peso para mas madali. So, total, ang lalabas na share ni Anastasio is 189,711 kay Balagtas 241,174 and kay Corazon 169,115. So, that's your answer for this problem. Okay? I think we're done or we're down to our last problem. So, our last problem will be this one. So, you are still going to distribute or allocate 600,000 in profits by doing the following. First, ibigay mo yung 10% interest based on ending capital. 80,000 salary to B. 15% bonus to A based on net income after salary and interest and bonus. Okay? After salary, interest, and bonus. So, yun daw yung basis ng bonus niya. Okay? Tapos, sharing the remainder in the ratio of the beginning capital balance. Okay, so for our last problem, or for our last illustration, let us compute for the profit share by following this. 10% interest on ending capital, 80,000 kay B, 15% bonus to A, that is based on net income after salary, interest, and bonus. And the remaining income will be distributed based on the ratio of the beginning capital balances. So let us compute. So this will be our solution. So for our solution, bigay natin yung interest na 10% of ending capital. Bigay natin yung salary kay B. Yung bonus computed as 15% of net income after salaries, interest, and bonus. So, that's going to be 15% of 600,000 minus 80,000 minus 83,900 minus B. Okay? So, pag nakuha mo na yung difference, so that's going to be 15% of 436,100 minus B. Okay? So, kunin mo yung 15% noon, that's 65,415 minus 15% B. So pag nilipat mo sa kabila, magiging 1.15 B yun, kasi magiging plus, is equal to 65,415. Tapos ang gagawin mo na lang is i-divide natin siya ng 1.15, we will get 56,883. So yun yung bonus natin doon. Okay? And then finally, we're going to distribute the remaining profit based on the ratio of the beginning capital. So beginning capital kasi is ito. So ang gawin mo, i-total mo lang, tapos i-divide mo ngayon yung total. Or pag nakuha mo yung total, i-divide mo yung capital balance nila doon sa total. Tapos i-multiply mo doon sa remaining profit na 379,217. So ito yung lalabas na amount. Tapos finally, i-add mo na lang. Okay? So pwede mo pa rin namang i-round off yan. So most probably in this case, this is going to be 218,121. Okay? Pagkatapos, this is going to be most probably this is going to be this is 200,386. Tapos this is going to be 181,493. Yun. So magbabalance pa rin naman. So hindi ko lang na round off na. So anyway, that's our answer for the examples ng profit sharing. Okay, so what are the probable other distributions na mangyayari? Ganun din, similar sa mga binigay nating example, iibahin lang siguro nila yung distribution percentages, iibahin nila yung capital balances, but the thing here, ang sikreto ng pag-solve ng profit distribution is simply to follow kung ano yung given na information sa atin. Okay? So that ends the illustrations for the basic profit sharing natin. Okay.